for the Magic, who eliminated Chicago 1 year ago. The Bulls looking for a little revenge. We have the sidelines well covered today. Let's start with Ahmad Rashad. Ahmad.
All right, thanks, Greg. Here in Chicago, Michael Jordan and I have a little ritual we go to. We always ride to the games together. And this morning, I noticed a very difference in his attitude. It was different from last year at this time. And I asked him about that. He said, well, last year, he did not have the confidence that he had had before. He had the motivation, but he didn't feel like his physical skills were there. He said, it's been a year later. He is confident. His physical skills are back. And he has one other plus. He said he feels like he has the edge that he had when Chicago won those three championships. One other injury update, Tony Kukoc, who's been out with a sprained back, will play today, although he will wear a back brace on his back just to keep it warm. Now for the Orlando side, let's go down to Jim Gray.
All right, thank you very much, Ahmad. Well, I spoke extensively with Shaquille O'Neal, and he told me the problem with his heart racing last week was all stress-related. He told me that he was stressed out about a number of personal things. First of all, these playoffs and trying to win a championship, as well as his grandmother passing away. Well, he said now he's just trying to relax and chill out, were his words, and that he is feeling much, much better and is not concerned at all about his heart. One other concern, however, for the Orlando Magic, and that has to do with Horace Grant. He hurt his right elbow in the second half of the fifth game against Atlanta. Now, he didn't score in that second half. He cannot extend his right arm, and it is giving him a problem with his shooting touch. Now, he has been icing it all week. He did not tell the training staff or the coaching staff because he did not want them to take him out of the game and lose time in this series, but it could be a big problem for him offensively, Greg.
All right, Jim Gray, as we get set for the opening tip, let's talk about what we expect in this game. Matt?
Well, Greg, Chicago wants to do what they do best, and that's play defense and create offense from that defense, get as many fast break baskets as they can, and they also want to get second shot opportunities behind Dennis Rodman, who does it so well. But the Magic big people also can do a very good job on the boards, and they also want to keep Dennis Scott and Nick Anderson from getting off beyond the three-point line.
Bill Orlando has to play strict man-to-man defense to cut down on offensive rebound opportunities for Chicago. Their front court bench has to do something. Penny has to believe he can beat Michael Jordan. And then Shaq's got to play with such rage, he's got to make the Chicago front court want to quit the sport of basketball.
The number one offense in the postseason, Orlando, 105 points a game. Chicago with the number one defense in the playoffs, yielding just 86.1 in the opening tap to Penny Hardaway and the Magic. The officials, Hugh Evans, Ron Garretson, Bennett Salvatore.
Terrific denying defense by Jordan on the wing.
Team.
Right off the bat, and that's been the big question all for the last couple of days in the preparation for Chicago, how they would defend Shaq.
Jordan back outside to Pippen on the run. Too hard.
When you gamble defensively, that allows Chicago to have open lanes to the offensive glass. Shaq, a weak effort on Scottie's runner in the lane, and nobody boxed off Longley.
Longley running O'Neal, steps in for the steal.
Longley's got a good offensive game. And when you have the attitude in your mind that, hey, Shaq's going to get his at one end, but you've got to come back and attack. If you just think you're going to be a fouler out there, you have no chance. Get it back on the offensive end.
Matt Duke has talked about the Scottie Pippen, Penny Hardaway matchup early on, and Pippen picked him up full court.
Scottie told us he wants to take him out of his comfort zone, and that's where it is right now, down on that left block. Well, Luke Longley coming off a very poor series against New York where he had actually more personal fouls. And then the rebound.
Terrible strike for Orlando.
Scottie Pippen. 6-0 Bulls. Nick Anderson back in a hurry. And picked off by Longley. Rodman leaves it for Harper, who goes down the lane for Rodman.
Dennis Rodman gave the ball up early to a guard in the midcourt area. got down to the baseline, spaced the floor beautifully, and everything possibly going wrong for Orlando has already gone wrong. Not a good look anywhere offensively. No establishing themselves at the basket area.
Bulls have jumped to a 9-point lead. Jordan taps it out of bounds.
Well, we see the defensive strategy, at least as far as the wing players are concerned. Michael Jordan trying to deny the ball to Nick Anderson at every opportunity, because that's where many of the entry passes go to Shaq.
9:50 to play, first quarter. Horace Grant at the free throw line. Comes up short. With the rebound, and the Magic still scoreless.
Again, that's not Horace's game.
Longley. And Pippen on the offensive glass, fouled by O'Neal.
Well, the biggest fear for Orlando is getting this crowd involved, and that's what the Bulls are doing right now with their aggressive defense, pushing the ball down the floor, getting after second shots, and just going right in the face of Orlando, and the crowd is involved. Brian Hill's biggest fear.
10 straight points for the Bulls.
Orlando has to come right back with their strength, with their game plan, and that's Shaq. He touched the ball the first play and missed. Just because he missed his first shot, you got to give him 30 looks all day long.
An unusual situation for the Magic in that they have never before opened a playoff series on the road. And a 20-second timeout now for the Magic. 9:29 to play here in the first. Season series so far. Bulls and Magic met four times. In November, Penny scored 36 to lead the Magic to victory. In December, at Chicago, Michael Jordan 36. The Bulls won by 9. In February, Tony Kukoc, 6 three-pointers and a romp by Chicago. And April 7th in Orlando, the game to which Shaq arrived late, it was Tony Kukoc and Michael Jordan combining for 47 points in a 90-86 Chicago Bulls victory. So far, the Chicago Bulls own the backboards. They've out-rebounded the Magic 6-1. Orlando 0-4 from the floor. It's a 10-0 Bulls lead.
The way the Chicago is playing with such energy and enthusiasm and intensity shows the respect they have for Orlando.
Another rebound for Rodman, and the Bulls on the run again. Harper back outside and stolen by Scott.
It's the first good play of the game for Orlando, and it comes 3 minutes in.
Looks like Orlando cannot settle in on what they want to do offensively. This is what they normally do as far as they'd like to get the ball to Shaq, but he just vacated the post there. And what they wound up doing is just going one-on-one.
Luke Longley just threw his first on the Nick Anderson drive.
Michael Jordan, you see how high he is, denying that entry pass. Nick Anderson in the post, a very good offensive scorer. When the wings, though, are fronted, Matt, as you know, when you were trying to feed Wilt all those years, when the wing gets fronted, you got to clear out back door, and the guard dribbles it over and then dumps it in.
Well, you always have to have that as a release, a pressure release with backdoor type of plays. But right now, the aggressive defense, Chicago, totally taking Orlando out of any kind of synchronization offensively.
The Orlando Magic went 3 minutes and 3 seconds before getting on the board. Anderson hit one of two, and it's 10-1.
Chicago, Orlando, no baskets. Rodman, 4 rebounds early.
Jordan on the follow. And O'Neal with the rebound. Hardaway down the line with the left hand.
Nice use of this back screen, almost a moving screen by Shaq in transition that time. You can dunk from the foul line with your offhand, your left hand. You've got a game.
Longley trying to bring Shaquille up high.
See, it's a totally different kind of Orlando type of defense. And Scottie Pippen hits the three. The Magic are sagging defensively. In the last series, when Chicago played New York, the Knicks were trying to get up into the face, into the chest of the Bulls. This is a little bit of a different way of going at it.
13-3. Bulls by 10, 7:50 to play in the first. And O'Neal breaks free underneath.
Luke Longley was trying to get up on the top side. In fact, trying to front, Scottie Pippen was dropping in the lap of Shaq. No pressure on the ball. Easy pass and dunk.
Longley brings it up to the top of the key, and now back to Pippen, and 10 on the shot clock. And there's an illegal defense call.
One of the toughest plays to defend in all of basketball. Pick and roll situations. A sudden one knocks off Scottie Pippen, and Luke Longley never moves his feet over, and Hardaway beats him with the quickness. And then miscommunication defensively. The easy pass over the top to Shaq.
Chicago Bulls call timeout as you take another look as Shaq gets the pass and the dunk. 7:28 to play in the first. We're coming right back to Chicago in a moment. Is there anyone on whom there are more eyes in a game like this than Michael Jordan? But he is only 0-for-1 from the floor so far. We asked Michael about those great expectations.
Everyone else has an expectation of Michael Jordan or what he thinks he's going to do or if he's going to come out and try to score 60 points. That's when I take a step back and say, let's go against the odds here. Let's try and get everybody else involved. Let's go the opposite way. Let's not go where they're predicting you to go. And I think that's a part of my challenge. And I know everyone, even though I've said all along, this is the game, this is a series that I've been looking for. But I'm going to try to do it through everyone else and not by, you know, just going out and making this revenge or, this redemption all my own. It's a team thing, and I'm going to do it within the measure of the team.
And let's check in with Ahmad. Ahmad.
All right, Greg, coming off that soundbite, reminded me, we talked about that this morning. He said, you know what, I'm going to try to get the offense involved and see who's going to step up. But if they don't, I won't wait long before I take over.
Well, Michael was saying to the media a few days before the series started that he was going to come out and shoot the ball every time he touched it. And Phil Jackson said, I hope he doesn't do that. He only wants Michael to do it when he needs those points.
Coming up on 6:45 to play in the first, the Bulls off to the quick start, 13-5. They lead. And traveling violation of Ron Harper.
I like the fact that the Bulls are moving the ball offensively, something that they didn't do well at all in the New York series. Now, granted, the Knicks are going to grab and hold you a lot. Today, the ball movement is crisp, it's sharp, and it's early. Nobody's standing around watching Michael play.
Again, Lukley, the only man on Shaquille. And Hardaway makes the screen drop. Scores.
Well, right now, Scottie Pippen doing a good job out on the floor pressuring Hardaway's handle. But once Penny gets low,
and Rodman missed the dunk. Jordan looking for a way around Nick Anderson, instead back to Harper.
Terrific defensive cutoff by Nick Anderson.
Longley. Luke Longley with 6 of the Bulls' 15 points.
Well, Luke knows he's always going to be open for that little kick-out pass. Shaq is not going to travel too far from the lane, so Luke will have that open 16-17-footer all afternoon.
I drive the ball right at Shaq and then kick it out.
Rodman stepped into the lane to try to help. Bulls wanted to travel. It's 15-9.
When Luke Longley fronts, a beautiful pass.
And blocked from behind by Hardaway. Way long. Back comes Chicago.
Shaq had the lob. They missed him.
Looks like Chicago is trying to take advantage of the Magic's problems with transition defense. They were looking to run there. The Bulls looked a little bit winded. Luke Longley barely got into the front court.
Shot clock at 3. Pippen. And Longley with the rebound. It back outside, and Ron Harper will slow things down. We are under 5 minutes to play for the quarter. Rodman is there for the follow.
The Magic's inability to contain penetrators just opened up all kinds of opportunities for Longley and Rodman.
And O'Neal will go to the line to try for the three-point play. Let's go back to the other end.
Well, this is out of the triangle offense for Chicago. The little handoff to Scottie Pippen, who had to try to make the acrobatic shot because of Shaq's presence and changing the shot. But Horace Grant unable to get the body on Dennis Rodman.
Matt, two players for Orlando did nothing against Scottie except force a tough miss. The other three Orlando guys standing on the perimeter watching. Poor rotations.
Tony Kukoc off the Chicago bench and was ticketed to wear a back brace for that sore back, but we are told he's decided not to wear it so far this afternoon. Making his first appearance since game two of the series against New York.
Well, Luke Longley gave him some offensive punch as Shaq can't get the free throw, but picking up those two fouls, and now Phil Jackson elects to go small.
But Orlando's right there. They're just down 6 points and have played as poorly as they can. Dennis Scott, poor defense away from the ball.
Bulls basketball. That's number one on Dennis Scott. Tony Kukoc in the throes of a horrible shooting slump. Kukoc just 1-for-24 from three-point range in the postseason.
The Bulls playing a skill and precision game while Orlando still thinking power.
Rodman lofted in the middle. And now Hardaway.
Jackson did not want.
There's the whistle before the shot. An illegal defense call against the Bulls.
Well, Dennis Rodman has had some success with playing Shaq. Even though Dennis only weighs about 218 pounds, he has a strong low base, able to push Shaq a little bit further out than he wants. No double team came there. If the double is going to come, it's going to come from the strong side of the floor, from the passer that enters into Shaq.
Mostly what Dennis Rodman has is a strong will. Put his body on the line against Shaq.
Three-pointer, no good. Kukoc with the rebound. Rodman just took a pretty good elbow in the mouth from Shaquille O'Neal. The Bulls with a 14-4 edge on the boards.
That just gets you going, Greg. A guy like Dennis Rodman looks forward to that. Terrific defense by Penny once again.
Hardaway with the steal on Jordan.
You can see how quickly the Chicago defenders come up on Dennis Scott in transition. They do not want to give him any kind of look at a three.
Hardaway on Pippen.
Like Chicago's fronting strategy defensively in the post.
Jordan comes away with it. And foul by Nick Anderson, who wants an offensive foul. Let's go back to the other end of Dennis Rodman and the problems you have dealing with Shaquille O'Neal.
Shaq is 7'2", Dennis about 6'6", 6'7". That elbow just comes right up. Chastain, if Dennis wants to bite him in the elbow, that's his problem.
Penny Hardaway with the steal, and then Kukoc. And Nick Anderson wanted an offensive foul.
Well, actually, that whole play started with a missed Nick Anderson three-pointer from the left corner, resulted in a long rebound, and that's when Chicago really becomes dangerous. Michael Jordan in the middle of the floor, Penny Hardaway with a bad gamble at midcourt against Jordan, and this set up the two free throws for Kukoc.
Kukoc hits them both, coming up on 3 minutes to play here in the first. The Bulls 19, Orlando 11.
Good to see Kukoc moving so freely and effortlessly. Have bad backs. They can take a long time to heal. Again, the front in the post.
Nice pass to Penny Hardaway. Went back door and got the stuff.
That's the pressure release there as the Magic are starting to read now as to how they're going to be played on the wing and how they're going to be played in post situations and making the nice pass.
Matt, when you get fronted, the postman has to move up and away from the basket to create more spacing.
Kukoc for three. And Rodman, rebound, trying to call a timeout and got it. It is a 20-second timeout.
Awfully early in the game to be burning timeouts just for a solitary possession when you already have the lead.
Well, Tony Kukoc looked so anxious to get that shot out of his hand, you wouldn't believe it. He's 1-for-24 in the playoffs from beyond the arc.
We are now extended to a full timeout. We'll come back. You're watching the NBA on NBC.
Scottie Pippen denying the post play to Penny Hardaway. Jordan pressuring Nick Anderson. No weak side help. And you're just not supposed to be able to make this good a pass under that kind of pressure. But Nick Anderson and Penny Hardaway pulled it off. And a look at the low angle. Same result. And against very tough defense.
the weak side, they have to anticipate the delivery of that pass and release quicker. Orlando guards shutting out the Bulls. Jordan with just one shot attempt.
Michael Jordan averages 23 a game during the regular season, 0 for 1 so far this afternoon. 2:26 to play here in the first.
Ahmad was relaying to us Michael's message about the ball movement, how they worked on that all week long in practice. Forget the dribbling, forget the standing around. Let's pass it and pass it quick.
Speaking of standing around, a bit too many people standing around on the sideline there. Scottie Pippen tries to inbound. Jordan. And there's a steal by Cooper.
Very sloppy play by Orlando.
Brian Shaw into the game now for the Magic, as is John Conkak.
And what Chicago's defense has done is just taken Orlando out of their game completely. Away from the basket to receive the ball.
There's a reach-in foul. Let's go back to the steal under the basket after the Michael Jordan jumper.
Jordan hits the jumper on the inbound pass, weak side screen. And then the inbounder, Brian Shaw, looks like, just has no clue that Tony Kukoc is sneaking up behind Horace Grant.
And Horace Grant, obviously bothered by that sore right elbow, does not even look like himself. He has been an absolute demon for the Magic throughout these playoffs, shooting 65% from the field in that last series, but he just cannot get involved in this ballgame.
Nick Anderson missed them both. Horace Grant, for the ninth consecutive year, shot better than 50% from the floor.
But he hasn't had a good look yet. There's been no penetration in dish. Everybody's staying home on Shaquille.
Harper to the far side. Jordan. Number one on John Conkak.
Well, this was all set up by Michael making his last jump shot, and he has recognized no Shaquille O'Neal to clog up the lane and be a shot block threat, knowing that if he can get by Nick Anderson, he can create something in there, and he got the slap and hack.
If you're going to hack down, make sure the guy does not get a three-point play.
Into the game, Randy Brown for Chicago, wearing number zero. 60-year man out of New Mexico State. Jordan makes it a three-point play. 26-13. Bulls have doubled up Orlando as we come up on a minute and a half to play in the first.
See how Chicago's defense is making Orlando work so hard to get the ball even up the court.
Hardaway double-teamed in the far corner. Looking for a way around. Pippen spins.
Wow, that was just a terrific play by Penny Hardaway, but he had to work so hard for it, as the Magic having to resort to pounding the ball to the floor, going one-on-one.
Pippen fouled from behind by Shaw, and a nice pass from Tony Kukoc. Let's go back to Penny Hardaway.
But the amount of time that it took Penny Hardaway to get the ball initially and then finally get the shot off, how many dribbles with no double team. The Bulls, though, playing without the ball. The weak side cutters flashing in. The Magic standing around watching the ball. Bulls playing like they did during the regular season.
Well, the Magic offense is so geared to the post game, throwing it into Shaquille O'Neal. Most teams are going to double team, and that's how they get open shooting opportunities, or post Hardaway and get the same thing. And with the Bulls, you see a completely different philosophy with the triangle offense. A lot of player movement, a lot of ball movement, much tougher to defend as far as moving your feet. Of course, when you're going to double team all the time against Orlando, that's a whole different story.
Scottie Pippen hits them both. The Bulls are 7 of 8 from the free throw line, compared to just 1 out of 5 for the Magic.
Jordan to the bench with a 13-point lead. He's only got 5 points and 3 shots. Things couldn't be better for Phil Jackson.
Steve Kerr onto the floor and guarding Brian Shaw now for the Chicago Bulls. Nick Anderson. And Conkak threw it away. Kerr for Pippen.
Obviously, the few days' rest has done wonders for Scottie Pippen's health.
10 for Pippen as we come up on the last half minute. The Bulls with of their biggest lead of the day, 15 points.
Isolation one-on-one. Now the two-man game.
And Kerr drew the foul.
Well, once the ball gets into the hands of John Konkak, a little bit of panic sets in as Nick Anderson gives it to Konkak. He just overreacts and threw it away as Tony Kukoc is really making his presence felt as a helper defensively.
Scottie Pippen finishing, as few players in the history of this game have done. Of course, Dr. J, Elgin Baylor, Connie Hawkins right up there. But we talked at the opening about the front court players for Orlando have to do something on the offensive end. John Konkak there just turning the ball over.
Chuck I like Whistler onto the floor for Chicago.
Excuse me, I like though what Chicago has done in going back to the full court press after they score. Getting up and making Orlando throw over the top. Jordan getting some rest. You know he'll come back soon, along with Shaq.
Anderson missed again. 30-16, last 15 seconds of the quarter. Bulls will hold for the last shot. For Whittington. Hardaway from half court. Chicago, and then Penny Hardaway nails a three from half court to close out the first.
I don't know if you guys heard it. I heard him call glass at the last second.
One more look at Penny Hardaway. Yeah, I think he did say glass. You're right, Manny. The Bulls, 32. The Magic, 19. Back for the second quarter in a moment. You're watching the NBA on NBC. In a first quarter dominated by the Chicago Bulls, Orlando got a lift in the final second. Penny Hardaway hitting a long three to make it a 32-19 Chicago lead. But Jim Gray, that doesn't make Coach Brian Hill a happy camper, does it?
Well, no, it doesn't at all, Greg. In fact, Brian Hill told his guys, it's like none of you want to shoot the ball. We have to get aggressive offensively. Everybody's standing around and just accepting what the Bulls are doing to us defensively. Quit standing around, work the ball around, get some better shots. Let's go down to Ahmad with the Bulls story.
All right, thanks, Jim. Well, the play of the Bulls has made Phil Jackson very happy. He said they had a very good quarter, very happy with the energy that they showed, but they realized that Shaquille O'Neal is coming back this quarter. They got to be ready for that. Greg?
All right, Ahmad underway in the second quarter. Pippen, Kukoc, Wennington, Steve Kerr, and Michael Jordan on the floor. And Kukoc, his miss, rebounded by Shaquille.
Penny's not looking to run the ball himself out of the backcourt. He's thinking he's a forward in this series, rebounding. Total domination by Chicago.
The follow is good. Penny Hardaway with 13 of Orlando's 21 points. 32-21 Bulls.
It's a mismatch here. Scottie Pippen has got Bowie on it.
Turnaround comes up short. Shaw picks it off. It up and he'll go to the line to shoot two.
Penny Hardaway coming into this series says he has a takeover mentality. He's going to do whatever it takes. The offense has bogged down, so he's looking to drop that hit, get into the lane, and Phil, there's nobody better in the league right now at following his own shot. That second quick hop off the floor, getting his own tip in.
But Matt, Penny is a guard. Penny is a person who knows how to control the whole game, and I think the fact that he's matched up against Scottie Pippen, he's thinking like a forward now and letting the other guys handle the ball too much.
Anthony Bowie on the floor for the first time this afternoon for the Magic. Jordan drops down to help with the double team. Shaw with the open jumper from outside. That's a three.
Well, there's the double team on the strong side of the floor. And with Brian Shaw not being a very good perimeter shooter, they'll live with that out shot. The Magic like the way that Brian Shaw can defend against Michael Jordan.
Jordan. Curry, his shot got rolled. Bulls by 10, 34-24. Randy Brown dropping down to help out. O'Neal backs in on Whittington and scores. Phil Jackson kind of priming the pump for the officials earlier this week, saying he hoped the officials would call that head-on charge by Shaquille O'Neal.
Obviously, Shaq has to move around players, but don't fade away. And don't wait so long for that double team to get them. Attack immediately.
Shot clock is at 4. Kukoc running out of time. Is it 2? Pippen with a long 3. And Kukoc lost the rebound. Jordan recovers. Terrific look from Tony Kukoc.
And where's Horace Grant been? Horace Grant has been such a spectacular player the last 2 years for Orlando. That elbow must be a lot more painful than he's let on.
Scottie Pippen has 12. 36, 26, Bulls by 10. Brian Shaw on the drive. Jordan rebounds.
Terrible team.
Michael Jordan's not real pleased with it either.
Well, Michael Jordan hemmed in by 3 Orlando Magic players right underneath the basket, thinking about calling a timeout, trying to escape. Nothing he could do. Shuffles the feet, and it is a traveling violation.
Nothing but Magic in the vicinity. It'll be Orlando ball when we come back. 9:16 to play in the first half. It's the Bulls by 10. A little less than artful work at the far end of the court here. Michael Jordan out of bounds, and then our own Dave Adkins making sure that that Michael has a soft landing. Six, 26, 9:16 to play in the first half.
Horace Grant finally to the bench, played the first 15 minutes, got one shot which he missed and one rebound. Not something you're used to seeing from Horace Grant.
Hardaway for 3. Get it. 36-29.
Bill Weddington just not strong enough to hold Shaq outside the lane. Did get hooked ever so slightly, but flopped on the play looking for the call.
Weddington with the jump from outside, missed everything.
When was the last time they ran a play for Bill Weddington to shoot a 20-foot jumper?
Donald Royal hits the deck hard. Boy, that's a popular place at the end of the court. Let's go back and look at Shaquille O'Neal on Bill Weddington.
Shaq keeping low. You see the ball in the triple threat position. Just bowls his way right through. Gores Weddington, if you will, and then throws Randy Brown out of the way. These little guys out from underneath me.
Ryan Hill looking for some kind of energy off the bench. Came with Anthony Bowie at the end of the first quarter. He usually provides it. And now Donald Royal, who has been a forgotten man in the Magic rotation, but he's a guy who will do what he just did on that last play. Every opportunity he sees any kind of opening to the basket, he'll drop his head and go.
Missed the free throw. The Magic now 2 of 8 from the line this afternoon.
They are a horrible free throw shooting team. The amazing thing, they're down 7 points. And have been outplayed in every aspect of the game, including out-hustle.
2 for 9 on the 2 misses. Set us Jordan, top of the key, gets the screen from Weddington. Comes back. Orlando coming back now with a chance to cut it to 5 or less.
Orlando's not fast breaking off defensive rebounds.
Shaquille and Rodman with another rebound. O'Neal took it away and scored.
Oh, work of art.
And Bill Weddington took a shot in the chin and jaw area for his trouble. And Bill, that's why the Magic have come with Anthony Bowie and Donald Royal. They will run the wings if the Magic can force a turnover or get a rebound.
Weddington going to try it again. Look. Front rim, Rodman on the offensive glass.
That's a terrible mismatch for Donald Royal or Anthony Bowie to try to mix it up physically underneath the glass with Dennis Rodman.
7.5 to play in the first. By 7 and the lob for O'Neal.
Bill Weddington just cannot keep his body on Shaquille O'Neal and offer any kind of resistance. And if you're counting it on, Dennis Rodman now 9 rebounds.
5-point lead for the Bulls. It was 115. Jordan for three. Got it. 10 points for Michael Jordan.
Brian Shaw in a hopeless situation, trying to slow down Michael, but some poor decision making as well.
Nice pass.
Beautiful pass to the cutting Anthony Bowie as O'Neal spotted the double team coming, and the attempt for the steal by Hardaway almost there. And this time he does take it away from Kukoc. The pass for Shaw back to Penny. Oh, beautiful passing by the Magic.
Well, that's what I was talking about. Penny Hardaway with that takeover mentality. He's going to do whatever it takes.
Hardaway trying for the steal, commits the foul.
A moment ago, why anybody would try to front Shaquille O'Neal and allow him to roll back for the love, the best in the history of the game. And then Penny Hardaway, who just refuses to let the Bulls get the ball over half court, creates an easy scoring opportunity.
The Bulls by four. We'll be back in a moment. You're watching the NBA on NBC. Who gets what pick and what players go where? The NBA draft lottery coming up at halftime. 41-37. Let's check in with Jim Gray. Jim.
All right. Thank you very much, Greg. Well, just a little bit more on Horace Grant's elbow. He did not want to tell the training staff or the coaching staff, first of all, because he didn't think it was a big deal. But it started to really bother him in that last game in the final quarter against Atlanta, and he realized he was really having a problem. Well, now he hasn't scored in 34 minutes, and he cannot extend his arm. So they're going to need him here in the second half, and maybe he'll get some attention to it. Greg?
Hits out of the corner, his first basket of the afternoon, and the Bulls have a 43-37 lead.
Well, Shaquille O'Neal and Penny Hardaway getting their production. Penny with 18, Shaq with 12, and none of the other Magic players really getting involved in this game.
Beautiful pass.
Brian Shaw breaking free for the pass from O'Neal. Shaw has five.
When Shaq keeps that ball down low in the triple threat position, he can make that dump over the top pass.
Longley to the left hook.
Look a little bit like Dave Cowens there.
And Longley back to make the steal. Pippen for Jordan. And that'll be a loose ball foul on Bowie.
This is a horrible mismatch here for Orlando. Coming off the bench with Bowie and Royal to try to play against Dennis Rodman. They don't have the size, the strength, and I have yet to see in their career the willingness to go out there and mix it up with such a physically intimidating player as Dennis Rodman.
But really, only Horace Grant is able to keep a guy like Rodman off the glass. Joe Wolf really doesn't have the strength or quickness to do it. Harper.
Oh, Dennis got ran by a rebound.
Scottie Pippen open. Rodman with a nice.
It's what he's doing. He is now looking to score, looking to make plays. He has really come out of the offensive doldrums. He had to do it in that New York series.
Speaking of looking to score, Luke Longley now with 10 points. And the shot is good.
Shaq is throwing up some wild ones, almost prayers. They've both been answered.
Jordan. 41. Bulls by 8, 4:45 to play in the first half.
Well, without any kind of pressure defensively from Orlando, the Chicago Bulls able to run their offense pretty as you please.
Shaquille comes up short.
The weak side screen down for Jordan has been perfect and there anytime they wanted it.
Rodman up high to set a screen. Nick Anderson, shot clock is at four. Ron Harper. And O'Neal with the rebound.
Now that is a rebound. A 7'2", 320-pound, whatever guy, moving up. Orlando getting killed on the glass. So just one offensive rebound.
And Orlando just getting a look at the basket on each trip down court now. Loose ball. Harper is there. And calls timeout. Possession for the Chicago Bulls. Dennis Rodman all over the glass. 12 of them so far today. And on the tail end of this one, a beautiful pass to Luke Longley. 3:51 remaining in the first half. Dennis Rodman, is he getting the crowd into it? You betcha.
Center. Now, Dennis Rodman is having an outstanding game, but he told me earlier today he's been bothered by a stomach virus. So every time he comes to the bench, he's filling up on oranges, trying to keep his juices together. But he says that he's a little bit worried about his stamina. So we'll keep an eye on that and keep you posted. Greg?
All right, Ahmad.
And his counterparts on the Orlando Magic, Horace Grant and Dennis Scott, have yet to score. They're 0-for-3 between them. Dennis Rodman in complete control of the forward position as he's greatly helped by Scottie Pippen.
Meanwhile, the conversation here in Chicago this week was, would the Chicago Bulls employ the hack-a-shack defense? Not so far today. O'Neal's been fouled just once.
Well, they said they do not want to do that. I think late in a close game, they will change that philosophy. But during the course of the game, three and a half quarters, they just don't want to indiscriminately foul. They would foul Shaq if they could get him before he could lay the ball in.
3:45 to play in the first half. Kukoc. Tony Kukoc with 6 in his return to action here this afternoon. 51-41, Bulls by 10.
A critical edge for Chicago in this series. Guys who can play basketball off the bench, fill it up with their own game, get jumpers.
Rodman grabs the loose ball. Kushner and Kukoc. Kushner.
That was not Dr. J to the room.
Report from the sideline is that Penny Hardaway cut his leg. He is on the sideline now, but he is all right. O'Neal shot, no. Harper comes away with it.
Isn't it amazing what a good defensive job Dennis Rodman does? He has the strength somehow to make Shaq take a shot rather than get bulled to the basket.
Rodman pulls it back outside himself. Shot clock down to 6. Jordan goes to work on Horace Grant. And O'Neal comes over for the foul. Would have been a tough shot right at the base, at the bottom of the shot clock for Michael Jordan.
Well, Horace Grant is isolated, but poor defensive switching. The Bulls are flashing from the weak side, coming back, and they're wide open at will. And then when Horace can't guard Michael Jordan on the perimeter, who can? Good hard foul by Shaquille O'Neal.
Big story in this first half. The Bulls outscoring the Magic 17-2 on second shot opportunities.
Judd Bushler open. His first basket of the day. Gives the Bulls a 12-point lead.
The Bulls just utilize their bench so much better. They get shots for guys who can't shoot like Bushler and Kerr.
Horace Grant not looking for a shot. Almost threw it away. And there's a foul called as Shaquille went into his move.
Horace can't create his own shot. Horace is a guy... Dennis Rodman is going to push and lean. Dennis was telling him yesterday, he'll do whatever it takes. He'll put his life on the line in guarding Shaquille O'Neal, which is often what happens.
Under 2 minutes to play for the first half. Bulls 53-41 lead. Penny back onto the floor and takes the lob for the stuff. Hardaway with 20 first half points.
And now wearing the tape on that leg to cover up that cut. Interchangeability of the Bulls offensive players.
Kukoc missed another 3. That's 2 3-pointers he's missed this afternoon. 1-for-26 in the postseason.
Coach Jackson trying to pump him up a little bit. He said, yeah, Tony, you're 1-for-50 the last time I looked at the stats.
Hardaway looking for a way around Jordan.
Look at the way Jordan is right there defensively to deny Penny the possession. They're making Nick Anderson bring the ball up the court. Brian Hill calling for the post play.
55 seconds for the first half. The lob for Shaquille. And Rodman catches him on the way down.
Well, Jordan's pressure defense forcing Penny to put the ball on the floor. A little help came over from Ron Harper, and that enabled Michael to get his hand in there to knock it loose. And every time the Bulls are able to force a turnover, it generally ends up into a good fast break play because the Magic are making these turnovers and have very poor transition defense.
Dennis Rodman guilty of his second personal. The foul committed before O'Keefe threw it down. Ron Harper gets an ovation as he leaves the court.
Well, they take Shaq out. No need to pick up his third foul. Shaq playing with two right now.
And whistle on the play on the far side. Foul outside. And John Sally draws his first. 39.2 to play in the first half. Bulls lead it by 12. They have led by as many as 15.
Well, other than Shaq's 7 for 11 from the field and 14 points, the offense for the Magic has been this man, Penny Hardaway, as he realizes right now his team is just not in sync. They're not able to get their normal post plays. They're not getting three-point looks. So what he's trying to do is at every opportunity get into the lane and create something for himself or for a teammate.
He's got 21 points, Matt, and what you're looking at in Penny Hardaway is the newest level of complete basketball player. I mean, starting with Jerry West and Oscar Robertson and Elgin Baylor and Connie Hawkins and Dr. J and Jordan and Bird and Magic. Now it's Penny.
Cool coach. Still can't find the range from three-point land.
But the job Jordan is doing defensively in denying the point guard possession of the ball, terrific.
Shot clock on the left, game clock on the right. Hardaway on Buschler, inside, rejected by Sally. Kerr has it. They still have 3 seconds. Sally trying to get a pass off, it wouldn't go. And Nick Anderson's lunge at the end of the first half doesn't connect. Pretty good first half, more for the Bulls than it has been for the Orlando Magic. Shaquille O'Neal, 14 points, 5 rebounds. Michael Jordan with 12 first half points. Penny Hardaway, 22. The Prudential Halftime Report coming up right after this.
More shots than Orlando.
55-45 as we get set to get started. And boy, the scoring load for the Orlando Magic has been carried by Shaquille and by Penny Hardaway, and not much else. The rest of the team has contributed just 9 points in all to the Orlando offense. That won't get it done today.
And the fact that Michael Jordan played 23 minutes and didn't have to work that hard. Sure, he was getting it done defensively, but normally you'd want to wear him out. So hopefully by the end of the game, you're going to have that one chance that he might be a little bit tired.
And a big mystery, the Horace Grant problem, saying that he hurt his game, hurt his right elbow in the last game. However, in the first half, his right wrist was heavily taped. He has taken that tape off.
With the basketball to start the action here in the second half. Game one, Eastern Conference Finals. Jordan with the shot clock at 5. Strong and off to the side. Scottie Pippen there for the rebound. Grabs his own rebound. Goes back on the baseline. Puts it in.
There it is again, Greg. Second shot opportunities on a lazy effort on the defensive boards. I think the Magic have to find Dennis Scott a shot and see if he has any kind of hot end. They wouldn't know with only one shot.
There's a throwaway by Hardaway as Scott fought for position.
Scottie Pippen taking advantage of a slow start in the second half, just like at the start of the game for Orlando. Every ball is so critical here. The Magic just casually thinking that this is going to be something. Hey, maybe I'll get it at the end.
Harper.
Penetration off the dribble again. Breaking down the Magic defense. Drawing the defense for an easy basket. And Brian Hill wants nothing of it. He does not like the way his ball clubbers come out to start his third quarter.
12 points for Luke Longley, who comes in averaging just over six a game, and a nice setup from Ron Harper.
Greg, at the beginning, we talked about the need to play one-on-one defense. Here, three guys can't stop penetration, and then no rotation. Ron Harper, what, he's got one basket in the game, and you're going to go out there and try to deny him possession? Phil Jackson in Luke Longley's face, talking about keeping Shaq away from the basket.
Luke's trying to figure out why. He said, I'm playing one of the best games of my life.
I've doubled up my average in the postseason today.
And we're up 14. Coaching, is it ever fun, Matt?
Well, yeah, you're never happy.
O'Neal, travel. Well, what a task facing Luke Longley today, huh?
Well, that's the call that Phil Jackson was begging for a few days ago, really, either the offensive foul or the travel, and really the lesser of two evils that time for Shaq and the Magic, the walk-off.
Lead at 61-45.
What Chicago is doing is brilliant. They're attacking Shaq on the defensive end, knowing he's a team defensive player, and then Longley just rolling into easy opportunities.
One-on-one. O'Neal got the bucket, and he'll go to the line. Luke Longley.
Longley,
that's number three on Longley.
The ability of centers to hit the jumper. Guys going up against the key like we saw with Seattle. Now we've got Shaq answering right back, just powering his way.
When he gets that kind of position, that deep in the paint, nothing Luke Longley or any defense can do. You can't even get there quickly enough, as Luke Longley certainly holding his own with Shaq. But I think the Magic have to get Shaq on the move a little bit. Not just stationary post-up. He's got to get more active and get involved in all phases.
Dennis Scott for three. No. Pippen is there for the rebound. Scott 0 for 2 from three-point land. This from the guy who set an NBA record, 267 three-pointers during the regular season.
And that one of those rare open looks, as Ron Harper has stayed very, very close.
But Dennis Scott has only taken three shots. Horace Grant has taken one shot. You have to assume the responsibility to get shots. You can't let other guys do everything for you out there.
Down low. Made the move to the baseline on Longley. Shaquille has 18, 61, 49.
Perfect pass by Nick Anderson. Shaq's got to move up the lane, though, when they go in that front. That'll give him more room.
Rodman. And that'll be over the back on Longley. That is four on Luke Longley.
The swing pass, the spacing, Shaq holds him off and then just can deliver. That's why Chicago is trying so desperately to pressure on the perimeter, and Luke Longley foolishly over the back. Although, as a center, you want your fouls to be on offensive rebound attempts and on block shot attempts.
Yeah, but Bill, I don't think in this case, in this series, Luke Longley, a key center for Chicago, they want to save those fouls for late in the game, and that's when they want to put Shaq on the line. You don't want to waste him there.
Hardaway lost the handle on his way to the hoop.
But now Chicago's got Rodman. They just bypassed Wennington. They said, we're going straight to Dennis Rodman here. Bulls. No time to lose.
Jordan Harper, Pippen, Kukoc, and Rodman. Jordan down the lane. Rodman's tip doesn't go. Anderson with the rebound. Orlando down 12. Looks to cut it to less. And Jordan with a foul from behind. That's number two on Michael Jordan.
A little frustration there by Michael, who made that penetrating move, looking to draw a foul, didn't get the whistle, trying to make up for it here by pestering Anderson on the dribble, went right over to the official and asked why he didn't get the call at the other end.
Hardaway spins over and goes to the other side of the basket.
And that's against one of the best defenders in all of basketball. This man is lethal in low post situations. Almost unstoppable. 24 for Penny Hardaway.
Penny just took one of the first team all-league defense players and got a layup off him at will.
At the other, Scottie Pippen, open jumper doesn't fall, and another rebound for the Magic, who are within 10 and looking to cut it down to single digits. Shaq calling for the ball, Rodman on him. Anderson for three. And Pippen with the ball. Trying for the steal from behind. Kufo comes away with it.
Chicago's scrambling defense has taken Orlando out of their offense.
Beckham with a wild left-handed shot. Rodman with the tap-in.
But again, Greg, attack Shaq. That opens up the glass for Rodman, for Pippen, for Harper, for anybody.
Back down to Shaq. Hardaway for three. Got it. Anthony Hardaway, 27 points, 63-54 Bulls. And timeout on the floor. Dennis Rodman with 9 points, hitting the offensive boards off the Scottie Pippen miss. And we take a break with 6:53 to play here in the third quarter. The Bulls 63, the Magic 54. Game one, Eastern Conference Finals. You're watching the NBA on NBC.
With the LDDS WorldCom message.
When we shoot commercial.
Commercial.
But we had something a little different in mind.
Hi, this is Michael Jordan.
This is Michael Jordan for LDDS WorldCom Long Distance.
Hello. This is for your home or business.
Come on, Mike.
One more minute.
The free, man.
You know, they have these prepaid calling cards, but this good-looking guy.
This is Michael Jordan.
LDDS WorldCom, telecommunication service that's one-on-one.
Over referee Bennett Salvatore, and the crux of their conversation was, you got to blow the whistle when Shaquille O'Neal starts to back in like a loose truck.
You have to work the referees. You have to create in their mind the fact that Shaq is going to lower that shoulder, get to the hoop. He's going to take steps. But the defender, they have to stay in there and take that punishment. Hakeem was willing to do it last year and got him a championship. The Bulls have done it so far in the first half of game one.
Hardaway going for the steal.
Well, Scottie Pippen has been getting brutalized by Hardaway with 27 points, and Scottie's been trying to answer primarily from the perimeter. This time, the Bulls come out of the timeout and go to a post situation for Pippen where he can be an effective player.
Hardaway, 11 of 15 from the field, 3 of 4 from behind the three-point line.
Greg, this is a very bad matchup on this defensive end for Orlando, with Shaq having to guard Dennis Rodman. Not that Dennis is going to score on him. But Shaq is not the type of player that can constantly lean his body on somebody.
Well, what's happening, Bill, is he's having to come over and help out defensively. That time he actually switched onto Pippen, and Hardaway didn't help the center out by getting a body on Rodman. But let's face it, nobody's got a body on him yet.
11 points, 16 rebounds for Dennis Rodman. 65-54 Bulls. Rodman now goes to work on the defense against the field. His jump shot is good. Pushing Rodman, and a technical foul, and Penny can't believe it. Happened as the ball came through the basket. Let's take a look.
Oh boy, that is a bad technical foul.
Michael Jordan misses the free throw.
Dennis Rodman had lost his balance. There was no push there. Oftentimes you're tangled up with players. A tough call by what is normally a great official in Hugh Evans.
Bulls took their first free throw since the first quarter, and Jordan missed it. Under 6 minutes to play now. 65-56. Jordan.
It's so effortless for Jordan, and they're not putting any pressure on him defensively with Nick Anderson not hitting his shots. Nobody from Orlando hitting from outside the paint.
Taken away from behind. Harper. 6.
Now this is why this Chicago team can win 72 games in a regular season. That doesn't get to 3, but when they do get the turnover, they strike quickly. That's what makes you a great basketball team. Pippen for 3. Harper. Chicago Bulls fans, 71-56. The Orlando Magic wondering just where the offense has gone. Nick Anderson and Dennis Scott, who average almost 30 points a game in the postseason together, they've managed just 2 points total today. Meanwhile, on the other side of the floor, the Chicago Bulls are a coach's dream. Complete and total balance in their offensive approach this afternoon.
Well, Scott and Anderson, along with Horace Grant last year, were the trio that killed the Bulls in that conference semifinal. And it's been a goal of the Bulls ever since to make sure that, in particular, Dennis Scott does not get off.
But this is the way the Bulls played the entire regular season. The ball movement spinning around, confusing the defense, and great defense leading to easy opportunities.
Scott with the giveaway.
This is a clinic.
The Bulls with their biggest lead of the day.
And Magic came out and looked to get Dennis Scott a shot. He was taken off, forced to put the ball on the floor, jumped in the air, turnover, layup.
O'Neal. Rodman may have gotten a hand on it.
Rodman, like Akeem, willing to get in there and put his body on shot.
Forget this man, Tony Kukoc, had a bad back, unable to play in the last 3 games in the New York series. He looks fresh.
His medication seems to be working just fine.
Shaq lost it. Dennis Rodman all over Shaquille O'Neal.
Michael Jordan stepping in the pass lane, never jumped to pass to throw a ball. Coming down, he finds Pippen. Got Jordan, Pippen, Kukoc, and Rodman coming at you on the break. You're in trouble.
Bulls have scored the last 10 points. Shot clock at 5. Jordan. Bounce it off of Grant's head, and that's out of bounds. The Bulls with 1 second on the shot clock.
And probably less than 1 because that put it. Clock was on 1 as that ball was rolling out of bounds. This could be a quick horn here.
Should have Dennis throw it in. Put all the shooters on the floor.
He's going to launch a 3.
Hook it.
Jordan. When it's your day, it's your day.
Brian Hill looks like somebody stole his luggage over there.
Says part of the game.
Well, Bill, you talked earlier in the ballgame about coming out with a rage. Beautiful feed from Kukoc on the out-of-bounds play as the Magic actually fell asleep there. You talked about rage. The way the Magic can get back into this and proceed in the series is start with a little rage here. The hard foul by Rodman, and Shaq has to get mad. He's got to be very disappointed with the way his team is playing. Not so much what he's doing or Penny Hardaway is doing, but somebody's got to fire up this Magic team right now. It's got to be out on the floor.
You know, I'd be quick to apologize and calm Shaq down, too. Shaquille now 0-for-3 from the free throw line this afternoon.
That's two old buddies, Scottie Pippen and Horace Grant. I asked Scottie before the game, I said, do you talk to Horace more than you talk to Dennis Rodman? He said, I think so.
17 rebounds for Dennis Rodman.
But the way this game has been so dominated at the power forward position by Dennis Rodman, and absolutely everything we talked about in the opening that Horace needed to do, hit the jumpers, control Dennis Rodman's emotional contribution, make something happen on the defensive end. That's embarrassing, those rebounds.
Rodman has as many rebounds as the Magic do as a team.
The crowd's talking.
back outside for Harper.
Now Chicago starting to toy with the three-second violation
against the Bulls. Here in the third quarter, the Magic, one more turnover than they have field goals.
Well, this used to be a hallmark of the Chicago Bulls. Championship teams come out in the third quarter, apply the defensive pressure, try to bury their opponent. They really haven't done it that much this year. They do get a stretch of minutes where they will bury their opponent, but it either comes late third, early fourth.
Hardaway into the lane and got the bounce. You know, Horace told us last night he expected some boos. I didn't think he expected a serenade.
Well, the way he's been so badly outplayed.
And now Horace just took a shot from Scottie Pippen. Pippen with the basket. Horace in pain at the baseline. And Brian Hill says 20-second timeout right here. An obvious pain for Horace Grant.
Well, you know, Greg, anybody can have a bad game. It just seems so unusual because Horace Grant has been playing such beautiful basketball in every area. And now he's trying to chase down to Scottie Pippen. And I thought he hurt his left elbow on this particular play when he first bent over.
Pippen cuts to the basket. Oh. A teammate came over and didn't help matters. We'll be back in a moment. Orlando forward Horace Grant being tended to on the bench after the collision under the basket just before the timeout. As we watch the replay, take a look at Shaquille O'Neal, who comes in and lays a lick on both his teammate Grant and Scottie Pippen. And Shaq is the only one left standing. Here's another look at it. Shaq coming in from the right side of your picture. And there is the shot to Horace Grant's left arm. Is what they were tending to over on the bench, and Grant will stay on the bench when the teams come back onto the floor.
A situation there where Horace's arm, as they help him off, is serious pain. Our Horace Grant, one of the toughest players in the NBA, but his arm got caught in between, and then the momentum of Shaq's incredible force just extended that arm in the wrong direction.
Jim Gray is checking it out for us. We'll get a report from him as soon as possible. Shaq hits the dunk.
Oh, that was a perfect pass by Brian Shaw. Almost it could have been called a goaltend right over the rim. And all Shaq had to do was stuff it through. And he's pressing right now as well.
Jordan. Michael Jordan has 18.
But now an effortless 18. But Orlando playing with an all-guard lineup except for Shaq. That's a foul.
You think?
I would hope.
And a hard foul. And Michael Jordan wanted to go over, pick up Penny. Little pat on the back, but he wanted to make sure as Horace Grant in obvious pain right now.
In fact, let's check in with Jim Gray right now. Jim.
All right, thank you, Greg. It's his left elbow. I just talked to Dr. Jim Barnett. He is the team physician for the Orlando Magic. They're going to go back right now and take some x-rays on his left elbow. He has a fear that it could be dislocated. He didn't want to diagnose that. He said it may also be a fracture. Those are just two preliminary thoughts. We'll have more information a bit later. Greg?
All right, Jim, for an Orlando team whose bench is woefully short and inadequate as it is, that would be a huge blow.
And now, going with a almost an automatic substitution to take Shaq out and give him a rest here. When you're down by as many as you are, you might want to think about keeping Shaq in the entire game.
30-point afternoon now for Anthony Hardaway. 30 of Orlando's 59 points. Kukoc tried the pass down low, but it was picked off.
Maybe the Bulls will get overconfident with Shaq out of there.
Maybe the sun will come up in the west tomorrow. Hardaway. No good. Loose ball. Hardaway had it and lost it, and the Bulls come away with it. And fouled underneath is Ron Harper.
The good news there for Orlando. They finally got a little bit aggressive on the offensive glass. Got a second shot opportunity. try to, it's very difficult to get a handle on this Horace Grant situation. We had gotten a report from Jim Gray before the game that it was his right elbow that he hurt at the end of the Atlanta series. In any event, it's Horace's responsibility to inform team doctors, trainers, coaches about any kind of injury and get proper treatment.
No good by Harper. Last 30 seconds of the third quarter.
Teams are just unwilling or entirely unable to play one-on-one defense against Chicago. And that just gives them so many tipping opportunities. I'm glad it killed the Knicks. It's held true today against Orlando.
Michael Jordan holding as the clock winds down. Jordan with 18.6 rebounds. Dennis Rodman, 11 points and 19 boards. The Bulls are in charge as we go to the fourth, 81-59. We're coming right back to the United Center after these words from your local station. At the top of our show, we've got to ask you, what do you think of this game so far?
A walk.
Yes.
Whoa.
We needed a little penny to tell us that.
Certainly has been a war for Horace Grant, unfortunately, in the locker room. Now, what Orlando has to do is come out and try to salvage some respectability after this game. Certainly not for Penny Hardaway, who's been brilliant. But where have the rest of the Magic been today?
Oh, 30 from Penny, 20 from Shaq, and just 9 from the rest of the Magic. Nick Anderson, 0 for 7. Dennis Scott, 0 for 3.
Yes, but Shaq with a 20-point performance when they're not double and triple teaming him. When that happens, you got to go for 40, 50, and 60. Well, how many did Wilt used to get, Matt?
Well, he averaged 50 the 1 year, Bill, but...
Well, in a big playoff game, if they didn't double-team, Wilt would get 60 or 70.
Well, back in those days, they rarely double-teamed. In fact, the only team to do it was the Boston Celtics. Casey Jones, very adept at coming down, waiting for Wilt to put the ball on the floor. Other than that, other teams can double-team.
Ron Harper with the steal. And he'll go to the line. 20 points for Michael Jordan.
Michael Jordan... feeding so quickly. You see how he anticipates and gets out in the lane. Now Michael Jordan able to finish on the break on his way tomorrow to pick up his fourth MVP trophy in his brilliant career. Still two behind Jabbar. Only one now behind Bill Russell with 5.
You've been keeping count.
I keep track of stuff like that.
21 points for Michael Jordan. Bill Wennington, and Kukoc comes over to help with the double team. Cross court, Penny on the drive.
And that's why Chicago does not want a double team from the weak side. The first time today that they came that way with Kukoc, and they're the kind of easy baskets that you get when you double team that way.
32 for Anthony Hardaway. Oh, the pass! Steve Kerr to Bill Wennington.
Sure, it makes all the sense that we'll have Kerr and Wennington play a two-man game and send Jordan and Kukoc to the weak side.
And that foul called on Bill Wennington. Let's take a look at that pass. What a sweet pass from Steve Kerr.
Well, under duress, deep in the left corner, being hounded by Anthony Bowie. Shaq out there to double-team, and Wennington does the right thing, heads for the basket, and Kerr able to deliver that ball from behind the back.
Steve Kerr grew up as a ball boy for the UCLA Bruins. Saw a lot of good basketball.
Shaq missed the dunk. Looks for the foul call. Didn't get it. The Magic are luckily to say, where did our forwards go in this game one as Wennington throws another one down?
Now, Brian Hill is furious. He felt that Tony Kukoc undercut Shaq on that dunk attempt, and Shaq stopped to look at the referee. Yes, he didn't get the call, but you can't worry about it. You got to run back.
Bowie's shot, no. Jordan rebound.
The Magic are just being out hustled. And the Bulls are quicker to every single ball. They're able to double team and get back.
And they're able to double team from the weak side with Nick Anderson and Dennis Scott out of the game right now. They're not really worried about the other shooters. Yes, they are worried about Penny Hardaway, however.
Here's the play that Brian Hill was furious about. And now Hardaway reaches down and grabs a hand, and he walks to the bench. 9:58 to play in regulation, and the Bulls are in charge.
Great Taste Runs in the Family brings you Miller Moments.
Today's moment takes us back 1 year. Bulls and the Magic, game one of the East semifinals. In the final seconds, the Bulls down by one. Michael Jordan has the ball knocked away by Nick Anderson. The ball picked up by Penny Hardaway. He finds Horace Grant for the clincher. The Magic won it 94-91. Went on to take the series 4-2. In recognition of that moment, the Miller Brewing Company donates $1,000 to the Thurgood Marshall Scholarship Fund. Speaking of Penny Hardaway, take a look at what happened on this last trip down court just before the timeout.
Well, the Magic getting caught up in a switch situation, and Hardaway really wasn't reading it and trying to get it. He got his hand caught on Michael Jordan's jersey. The rebounding has been the biggest story of this game so far. The Magic being out-rebounded 49-19 and outscored 25-2 on second shots.
Ouch. 19 rebounds for a team that has been averaging 41 during the postseason. Anthony Bowie with the jump shot, 88-63, as we come up on 9.5 to play in regulation.
It hasn't just been rebounding. It's been attitude and aggressive defense, and that's how the Chicago Bulls came out to start this series, and the Magic came out flat.
From the opening play of the game when the Bulls went up 10-0.
Shaq knew he made a mistake as soon as he touched that one. The ball didn't look like it had a prayer of going in. Shaq comes over.
I don't know if it was even going to hit the rim.
No. Donald Royal off the glass.
Dennis Scott and Nick Anderson have to be sitting over the bench saying, why didn't they play defense like that when we're on the floor? Come and double team like that, because that's how they get their openings.
So many of these opportunities come for Orlando with Dennis Rodman on the bench. Nice pass, Pippen.
Wellington, no. Bushler with the rebound. Pippen for three. The Magic come back. Hardaway to Shaquille down the lane for the layup. So Shaq adds another two. He has 22. 90-67.
The Bulls so quick. Oh, Pippen on the back door.
Oh, Steve Kerr.
Boy, the Bulls have been beating the Magic off the dribble all afternoon long, but you don't expect Steve Kerr to take you off the dribble to that extent, going in and laying it up unmolested.
Donald Royal hits his second straight shot, 92-69. And again, 69 points for the Magic, the highest scoring team in the playoffs with 105 in the 8 games played up until this afternoon.
And the Bulls played such poor offense against the Knicks. Creative passing. They're just toying with them at this point.
Steve Kerr for three.
Brian Hill walked up the sideline, thought about saying something, and then realized there was nothing he could say.
Shaq down the lane, draws the foul. Boy, Brian Hill, when he goes back and looks at the final numbers, it won't be much of a mystery as to what the problem has been this afternoon. Hardaway 32, Shaq 22, and the other three starters just 2 points among them.
But that's been the motivation of the Chicago defense. They know that Shaquille O'Neal and Penny Hardaway are going to score no matter how you really defend them, and their decision was, let's keep the other people from getting involved and hurting us.
Dennis Scott averages 13.5. Horace Grant almost 17. Nick Anderson 16.5. That's unbelievable. Hardaway got the roll, and he'll go to the line. 34 for Anthony Hardaway.
Penny Hardaway again. He's done it with Michael Jordan. He's done it with Scottie Pippen. Whoever they put on him. They haven't tried Dennis Rodman on him yet. Dennis is busy taking care of Shaq. But Matt, back to your point, that's not all the Chicago Bulls defense of staying at home with Nick Anderson and Dennis Scott and Horace Grant. You got to do something out there. You can't just go out there and wait for everybody else.
A playoff high, 35 for Anthony Hardaway. 34 making for Hardaway. Kicks it to Wennington. Royal with the rebound and the quick outlet for Hardaway. The Magic come back 4-on-2. And Hardaway slows it down. Bowie from the far side comes up short.
Kruko's tremendous extension and range on the defensive end.
And we get a timeout on the floor with 6:27 to play. The Chicago Bulls en route to a Game 1 victory in the Eastern Final. Then it's the special one-hour season finale of Mad About You and the world premiere movie A Friend's Betrayal starring NYPD Blues' Sharon Lawrence. That's all coming up tonight here on NBC. Greg Gumbel, Matt Gukas, Bill Walton, 6:27 to play here in the fourth quarter. The Bulls in charge, 95-71.
Bill, you talked a little bit earlier about Dennis Scott, Nick Anderson have to find ways to get involved. You got to make Dennis Scott an entry passer from time to time. You got to get him involved in some pick and rolls, baseline screens, pin downs, because the Bulls making that concentrated effort not to let him catch the ball and hurt them.
How about running the floor and getting an offensive rebound? Setting a screen for somebody to get open.
Well, there are lots of ways you can help your ball club, but Dennis Scott is that type of player, more like a shooting guard, that you have to find ways to free him up. And Nick Anderson, basically in that same situation, you got to create some shots for him as well.
Meanwhile, foul number 4 of the game on Dennis Rodman, who discusses it with Bennett Salvatore. Continues to discuss it. Some long faces on the Orlando bench. At the free throw line today. Hardaway hits that. The Magic are now 6-for-18 from the free throw line.
This will be the fourth straight game that Chicago has beaten Orlando. And you have to start wondering what kind of adjustments can Orlando make? Now, granted, Shaq only played in 1.5 of those regular season games. But Chicago's defense has been stifled. They have the best defense in the playoffs. But Orlando's offense is number one.
Move to the hoop.
Well, I can hear Brian Hill's speech already. The first word out of his mouth is going to be rebound, and then it's going to be attitude. You got to come out with a fierce attitude in game 2.
Hardaway for 3.
Matt, I'd start with pride. I wouldn't talk about X's and O's. I'd talk about this is competition. This is great basketball players head-to-head, and you got to know how to win.
Steve Kerr, top of the key, got it. 3 more for Steve Kerr, and the Bulls hit the century mark, 100-75. On the drive, no, rebounded by Rodman.
What an outlet.
Rodman with 21 rebounds, and he hits that shot. 13 points, 21 boards for Dennis Rodman.
If you're the Orlando Magic, you're saying it's bad enough you're giving him 20 rebounds, and you're really not giving it to him. He's earning them, and then he's going to score on you. You really have problems.
Shaq down low, got fouled. He'll go to the line. Right now, let's check in with Jim Gray. Jim.
All right. Thank you very much, Greg. I'm here with John Gabriel, the general manager of the Orlando Magic. He just left Horace Grant. What's Horace's condition?
X-rays show, Jim, that there's no fracture of the left elbow, but that he did twist it. It's very, very sore right now, and they're trying to mobilize it right now.
Do you have any prognosis, or will he be able to play and continue in the series?
Well, it's hard to say right now. They're even having difficulties getting his elbow into a sling, so I don't know that we're going to see him in the immediate future.
Is he suffering a tremendous amount of pain?
Yes, he is.
John, thank you for your help.
Okay, Jim, thank you.
Back out to you, Greg.
All right, Jim, thank you. John Sally fouled on his way to the basket. Meanwhile, at the other end, Shaquille O'Neal missed a free throw. He's 0-for-5 from the line today.
Orlando coming with a press. And
Chicago just breaks it beautifully. They flash a ball handler, Buschler, into the middle. Quickly, he turns and turns it into a fast break. And then Rodman finishes on the break.
I think Dennis Rodman has been fooling with a lot of people the last two, 3 years in San Antonio in particular, and really all of this regular season, and even his last couple of years in Detroit, in that he had the image that he didn't like to play offense, didn't care about scoring. All he wanted to do was play defense and rebound. As Scottie Pippen hears it from the sold-out crowd here at the United Center, but when Dennis Rodman gives you that offensive punch, plus the rebounding, you've got something special.
18 points, 8 rebounds for Scottie Pippen this afternoon.
I think what Dennis Rodman has shown us is that he cares about winning. Last year, Spurs, where he played, they were the best regular season team. This year, again, he chased down that regular season best record.
Donald Royal trying to get the pass to Brooks Thompson. Kerr picked it off. Back from the Bulls, 3-on-1. Rodman. Looked like he took a facial.
He was going to dunk that thing.
Like that.
Oh, boy.
Not like that. Something like that.
There is Horace Grant now leaving the locker room for the Orlando Magic. 102-79. Under 4 minutes to play. Randy Brown.
Again.
And Sally.
Not a good sign for Orlando with Horace looking in pain like he is. And no question, Shaq and Penny, the focal points of this Magic team. But you cannot discount what Horace Grant means in so many different areas, in particular the experience factor and the fact that he is a member of 3 championship teams. But you can see on the face of Horace Grant the kind of pain he's in. He missed 19 regular season games this year. The Orlando Magic went 10-9.
The very telling numbers on Horace Grant. 29 minutes today, 0-for-1 from the floor, no points, 1 rebound, no assists. It all spells trouble for Coach Brian Hill. Shaq hits a free throw for the first time today. 1 year ago, well, regular season, Horace Grant shot 51% from the floor, 9th straight year he's done that. In fact, Horace Grant had an outstanding regular season, scoring 13.5 points a game and grabbing more than 9 rebounds.
In game 3, Horace against Atlanta in the previous series, as Curry continues to just light it up. And Horace had one of those special games, 29 points, 20 boards. Penny Hardaway, all he can look on in embarrassment as Orlando calls a timeout. Once again, beautifully.
3:07 to play. The Bulls have this one in the bag. We'll be back to Chicago after this. Welcome back, everyone. 3:07 to play in the fourth quarter. Greg Gumbel along with Matt Gukas, Bill Walton, Ahmad Rashad, and Jim Gray. The Bulls lead it 107-80, and it looks like Shaq will spend the rest of this afternoon on the bench. Game 2. Later this week, Brooks Thompson with the jumper.
Orlando didn't get anything done today. They didn't put any sort of fear in Chicago's mind. They did show that Penny Hardaway could come out and do what he wanted. But no pressure on Jordan. No testing of Kukoc's back. No forcing Scottie Pippen to come out and make tough shots.
And no answer for Dennis Rodman on the offensive boards in particular.
Steve Kerr with yet another steal. And now the pitch line, Randy Brown.
Steve Kerr's playing like John Stockton out here. He's just toying with guys. Teasing him. Here it is. Nope. Turn around.
109-82, 2:15 to play. Joe Wolf. Buschler for 3. And the Bulls roar it off. Joe Wolf again. And Brown with the rebound. Outlets for Sally. Who scored?
I don't think John Sally can dunk anymore.
Brian Shaw, front rim. Kukoc with the rebound.
Well, you know, in some respects, if you're Brian Hill, you're almost glad that if you're going to lose one, that it is in this fashion a blowout, because there'll be no problem in getting everybody's attention tomorrow at practice as to what they have to do to come out and be ready for game two.
Two coaches to turn around. Orlando's worst previous playoff loss was by 27 to Indianapolis in 1995.
Greg, you mentioned earlier that Orlando has never started a series on the road. This is their first. They have a short playoff history. When they lose the first game, they not only have never won a playoff series, they never won a game in that playoff series.
Steve Kerr having himself a good old time on the floor. We're under a minute to play. Foul is on Randy Brown.
And if you're Phil Jackson and his coaching staff sitting over there, you're saying, gosh, I wish we could bottle this.
In a seven-game series, 41 of the last 49 opening game winners have gone on to take the series. And the Magic about to suffer their worst playoff loss ever.
And you can see the look on that man's face. Michael Jordan said he knows this is a long series. This is just one game. You cannot win or lose a series after just one game, although this was rather decisive.
This game today, obviously you fixed it.
Well, we had a chance to go back and practice and get ourselves back in rhythm. We had a couple of guys that were injured and not really feeling well, but then we got back in the gym and we worked out the kinks, and you know, we came out and played extremely well.
It seemed to me that this game was not about, Bill Walton mentioned it during the game, that it wasn't about X and O's. It was about rising to the level of competition.
Yeah, this is probably the best fun that you can have in the game of basketball. You know, come out when everything is at stake and play the type of basketball you want to play. These are fun games. A lot of people want to put pressure on themselves, but today I just came out and said, let's have a good time, let's play hard and see what happens.
All right, great game, Michael. Congratulations to you. All right.